Well, if you've ever gotten a haircut or gone on a ride in an amusement park or fried eggs in a Teflon pan, you've got some Kansas City imaginations to thank for it. KMBC 9's Jill Nichols has the explanation from the Kansas City Museum's Corinthian Hall.
Have you ever wondered where this came from or that came from or who made up that or who came up with that? Well, here at the Kansas City Museum, you can get all those questions answered. That's the idea behind this exhibit.
That's the idea is all about Kansas City inventors. It's a very unique group of people. Quite a bit of our 7 inventors in this exhibit are 19th century born. Some of these inventors invented the one thing and made their livelihood from it. Others just invented and invented and invented, and it was just the art of invention, the idea of keeping their minds going, that kept them going. I don't know that any of our men were ever truly multimillionaires because of that one invention or patent, but they all had that spirit of energy to keep inventing, to keep looking for the next innovation.
Sometimes innovation is all about bringing together things you wouldn't necessarily think go together, like Teflon was created by DuPont, but Marion Trizzolo, Kansas City's own, decided let's put that on a frying pan, and now we've got Teflon-coated frying pans, or as the Trizzolo family calls it, the Happy Pan. I'm happy. George C. Hale was fire chief in 1882. He invented a lot of things that help firefighters do their job, but he also invented something fun, an amusement park. Using film, you'd sit there and think you're on a train. He made that all happen. So every time you go to an amusement park and go, ah, you think of George C. Hale. Yes, that's how I would do it, Mr. Kaufman. This is Samuel M. Kaufman. He invented all kinds of different things. For example, electrical barbering. Look at over here. Look at all these gadgets. This was sort of like a lazy Susan of good grooming that barbers could use. You had a massager and a trimmer and a shaver, all from the brain of Samuel L. Kaufman. And that's not all. Samuel M. Kaufman also liked vending machines, so he created a lot of different vending machines. Like this one back here, that's a perfume vending machine, and that perfume is still available in high-end stores, believe it or not. And then there's a stamp vending machine where you can get your stamps for nothing. And this one is fascinating. This is an insurance vending machine. For a nickel, you can get $1,000 worth of insurance for one day, maybe if you're traveling or doing something really dangerous. Herman Stuckenberg came to Kansas City in 1881. He did a lot of fascinating things, but especially he invented this right here. This is a brick-making machine. A brick-making machine! So from now on, when somebody says, Nichols, you're dumb as a brick, I'm going to say, well, Herman Stuckenberg would have liked me. Joel Nichols, dumb as a brick, KMBC 9 News. I love that machine.
And that's the idea. It's called We'll Be on Display for Free Wednesdays through Sundays until September the 8th.